Dear students, we were on the example number 1.13. Actually, it was given you as a homework. I think you solved this, but don't worry, you just match your answer with my work, right? You just see, or let we are going to solve this example. See, what is the situation? What is the case? The two spheres are given. Charge on both spheres is same. Charge on the first sphere is Q, charge on the second sphere is Q, they are separated by some distance R. We are having the third sphere, that is charge Q equal to 0. The third sphere has a no charge. In the first case, we have to bring the sphere C with in contact A. Right? So when we bring sphere C nearer to the A, what will happen? We have already studied, think on it, right? So when we bring the sphere C in contact with A, the charge will divide. First of all, we will add the charge. What is the charge on A? That is, what is the charge on A? That is Q. What is the charge on C? That is 0. So total charge of the system becomes Q. Now charge at the time of separation, the charge will divide. So total charge is Q, right? So it multiplied by half, divide. Nah? So that's why it becomes Q by 2. So Q by 2 is the charge on sphere A after the separation, and charge on sphere C will also become Q by 2. Right? After the separation, charge on C becomes Q by 2. And after the separation, charge on A becomes Q by 2, right? So this is the first case. Now, in the second case, now the C having charge Q by 2, the B having charge Q, when we bring the C sphere C in contact with B, what happens? C, charge on C is Q by 2 plus charge on B is Q. Total charge becomes 3Q by 2. So this is the total charge. Now at the time of separation, charge will divide. So multiply it by half. So you will get 3Q by 4. So after the separation, charge on B becomes 3Q by 4 and charge on C becomes 3Q by 4. After the separation, in the second case, the role of C becomes over. Now C is out of the picture. C is now out of the picture. Right? So what we calculated? Now the charge on A is Q by 2. Charge on B is 3Q by 4. At the same separation, what is the force between A and B? That we are going to calculate, right? So to calculate the force, we will use the formula, that is equal to F, repulsive force F equal to KQQ divided by R square. So K remains as it is. What is the value of Q? Charge on first sphere, that is Q by 2. What is the charge on second sphere? That is 3Q by 4 divided by R square. Correct. So 4 multiplied by 2, it becomes 8. So Q remains as it is. Q into Q becomes Q square. Here it is R square, and it becomes 3 by 8. So what is this? It is a F. 3 by 8 into F. At the time of, suppose sphere A, sphere B having charge Q, initial condition, separation is R, so F equal to, we can write K Q square by R square. This was the initial case. So here we can replace this KQ square by R square equal to F. So this F equal to, right? And in the exercise 1.12, we already calculated the value, right? You can put the value, that is near about, I think that is what is that answer? It is 1.5 3 by 8 into 1.5 10 to the power minus 2 something, right? So by solving this, you will get the answer 5.740 10 to the power minus 2 is your force, right? So this is your answer, and this force is a repulsive one. Minus 3 is your answer. So by doing the calculation, you can get this answer. Or any query, you can comment me in the comment box, right? So this is your example 1.13, students. You can take the picture, and after that we will go to the next question, 1.14. Now we will see the example number 1.14. Up to that, you just read the question in the textbook, exercise example 1.14. The diagram is given, the positive and negative plates are given, right? Positive, negative plates are given, and the three charged particles are moving in an electric field. See, this is the positive plate, this is a negative plate, this is the positive plate, this is the negative plate. Exercise example 1.14. Right? Example 1.14. Yes. So these are the three charged particles. Suppose charged particle, let me see the diagram first of all. See, the first charged particle is moving in the electric field like this. This is the diagram. This is the path of the first charged particle. So path of the second charged particle. This is the path of the second charged particle, and this is the path of the third charged particle. Right? So these are the three charged particles. The first question is, give the signs of the three, give the signs, right? Means the charge, first charge is positive or negative, second charge particle is positive or negative, and find the third charge is positive or negative. So we have to find the signs of the charges and find the which has highest charge to m ratio. Q by m, charge to mass ratio. Which particle has a highest ratio of Q by m? That we have to calculate. First of all, you just observe the diagram. Positive plate, negative plate. Obviously, electric field lines are from positive to negative. So this is the uniform electric field, first of all, right? This area between the two plates, it is a uniform electric field. See the first particle. When the first particle is deflected toward the positive charge particle, hence the first charge particle must be a negative, right? See the second charge particle also deflected toward the positive place, it means it is again a negative charge particle. Here we can say that suppose the third charge particle is deflected towards the negative charge particles, obviously it will be a proton or it will be a positive charge particle. So it is negative charge particle, it is negative charge particle, and it is a positive charge particle. These things we have completed. Suppose the distance of the plate is, suppose L is the length, V is the velocity of the moving charge particle, right? So here the charge particles are moving in the electric field. They are accelerating, that we can see that. They are accelerating in the electric field. So here by using, see, it is the, if we draw like this, so this is the deflection for the first charge particle, this is the deflection for the second charge particle, and here is the deflection of the third charge particle. So here is the deflection of first one, second one, and third one. These are the deflections of charge particles. So the deflection is along y-axis, we can see that. So y equal to, or using the equations of motion, students, using the equations of motion, d equal to v0t plus half at square. using this equation. Displacement is along the y-axis deflection, so we will replace this d as a y. They are accelerating in the electric field. We can see that case of free fall, so initial velocity becomes zero. So initial velocity becomes zero, that's why zero multiplied by time becomes again zero plus half acceleration. So we can calculate F equal to M into A, so A equal to F by M, but F equal to Q into E. We can write electrical force, that's why Q into E. So replace this A by QE by M. So instead of A, we'll write Q into E by M into T square, that we can write. The time is same for this, but we can write Y equal to half of Q, means charge particle, right? So Q into E divided by M, correct? Next, T. What is the basic definition? Velocity equal to distance by time. Distance is L over here, suppose, or we can write L by T. So what is the value of T? So we will calculate T equal to L by V, we can write. So instead of T square, we will write L by V square, sorry, L by bracket of V square or D by V square, whatever you can write. So here we can say that the ratio of Q by M obtained over here, the electric field is same for all the three charge particles, length is same for the all three charge particles, velocity of the three charge particles is also same. So that's why the displacement is depends on Q by M ratio, because the E, L and V are constant here. So Y is directly proportional to the ratio of Q by M, right? So the particle having more deflection has a highest ratio of Q by M. So far by observing the diagram, we can say that the deflection of third charge particle is more. So therefore the Q by M ratio is also more for the third charge particle. See, once again, the deflection is directly proportional to the Q by M, vertical deflection we are talking, right? So Y equal to this vertical deflection is directly proportional to the Q by M ratio. The vertical deflection of the third charge particle is more. Vertical deflection of the third charge particle is more. That's why the ratio of Q by M is more for the third particle. So this is the end of your numerical, example number 1.14, right? So you just take the screenshot. We will move towards the example 1.15. Okay, see example number 1.15. Exercise example 1.15. See the question. Consider the uniform electric field. Okay, see electric field E equal to, we can write 3 into 10 to the power 3 newton per coulomb. I cap means it is acting along the x-axis. I cap means it is a vector, right? What is the flux through the field to the square of 10 centimeter on the side whose plane is parallel to the yz plane, right? So yz plane, first of all we will draw the yz plane. See, this is the y plane, this is the z plane, suppose this is the x axis, we can draw like this, right? Second question, what is the flux through the same square if the normal to its plane makes 60 degree angle, right? So first of all, the plane is yz plane. Yz plane is of side 10 centimeter. So this is 10 centimeter. This is also 10 centimeter. Yz plane means we can suppose here this line is considered as y-axis, this line is considered as a z-axis. So this board, this green board, is considered as a yz plane. So students, we can say that this chalk is a area vector. This area vector perpendicular to the plane, we have considered that this green board is a yz plane, right? This is the y-axis, this is the z-axis, same diagram we can discussing over here. So this chalk shows the direction of area vector perpendicular to the plane. We can put the area vector over here, right? So electric field is along the x-axis, so x-axis is again towards you, right? X-axis is again towards you. This is the y plane, y-axis I have told, this is the z-axis. So obviously x-axis is towards you. So the x-axis and area vector both are coming towards you. So here what we can write, here area vector is along x-axis and electric field is along x-axis. So area vector and E vector, angle between, here angle between area and electric field, area vector and electric field is 0 degree, right? So the question is find the flux. So flux equal to, we can write E vector dot A vector. We can say that flux is a scalar quantity. So E A cos theta, right? So what is the value of E? That is 3 into 10 to the power 3. What is the area? Area equal to what? 10 multiplied by 10. So we can calculate area over here. Area capital A equal to 10 centimeter multiplied by 10 centimeter, you can calculate. So right, 10 to the power, here we can say that 10 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2 meter, 10 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 2 meter, right? 100 multiplied by 10 to the power minus 4, we can write 100 10 to the power minus 4, and cos 0 is becomes 1. So by solving this, you can get your answer, that is near about 30 newton per meter square. 30 newton per meter square, meters per coulomb, right? This is, or Weber we can write, newton meters square per coulomb. That is your SI unit of flux, correct? The next question, students, this is the A part of this 1.15, and now we are moving towards the B part. It's a very simple question. Once again, see the B part. Again, the theta is given over here. Theta is equal to 60 degrees given. Theta equal to, yes, it is 60 degree given. So you can easily calculate. So flux equal to E A cos theta. Value of E is given, that is nearly 3 into 10 to the power 3. Area equal to 100 10 to the power minus 4. And the value of cos 60, that is half. By doing the calculation, you can calculate the flux, and that is nearly equal to 15 newton per meter square. Sorry, 15 newton meter square per coulomb. This is your answer, right? Here is the end of this example 1.14. In the next video, we will see the next example, that is 1.15. Thank you.